that is known as the fistia. Okay, so it is at water. They are freely float on that water. Okay. Eicornea, after that lemna. Eicornea. It is also water hyacinth. It is known as the offset. Subarrestal modification, I am also explained before that. So these are the balancing roads. These are freely float in that, float on that water. That is known as fistia and eicornea. After that lemna and after that salvinia. Okay. So that is known as free floating hydrophytes. Okay. After that, rooted hydrophytes. Rooted hydrophytes with the floating leaves. Okay. So these plants are rooted. Generally, the rooted plants are float on the surface of water by the long petiole. The plants having long petiole. So that leaves are float on water. Okay. So this rooted plants having that long petiole, due to the presence of long petiole, okay, this large leaves are float on that water. Large leaves float on water. Example, Nymphaea, and Nilambo. Nilambo means, that is known as that lotus. Nymphaea means, that is known as that water lily. Okay. So in that, rooted hydrophytes with floating leaves. For example, generally, stem is the rhizome. The roots are submerged in the water due to the presence of long petiole. By the presence of long petiole, they are freely float on that water. Okay. They are freely float on the water. That is known as that Nymphaea nilambo and that lotus. Rooted hydrophytes with floating leaves. Okay. The plants having long petiole. By the presence of long petiole, so the leaves are float on that water. Nymphaea and nilambo. They are known as that rooted hydrophytes with floating leaves. After that, submerged suspended hydrophytes. So these plants are completely submerged in the water, but they are freely float in that water. Okay, they are known as submerged suspended hydrophytes. The plants are submerged and suspended it means in these plants roots are not touch that soil. Okay, so they are float on that, they are okay, flow in that water, they are float in that water. The plants are submerged and suspended. Okay, roots are not contact to soil. These are not in these plants, in these plants in this roots are not contact to soil. Roots are not contact to soil. They are known as the submerged suspended hydrophytes. Okay. After that, submerged suspended hydrophytes example, hydrilla and Utricularia. Hydrilla and Utricularia. For example, it is known as that hydrilla. They are completely present in that water. They are completely present in water. They are completely present in the water, so that is known as that hydrilla plant. Okay. So they are known as submerged suspended hydrophytes. After that, submerged rooted hydrophytes. Submerged rooted hydrophytes. So in that submerged rooted hydrophytes, these plants completely submerged in the water, then roots are connected to the soil. Plants are completely submerged in water. The plants are completely submerged in water and roots are contact to soil. Contact to soil. Okay, that is that known as that submerged rooted hydrophytes. It means in this, these plants are completely present in the water and the roots are also contact to that soil. Okay, so that is known as, they are known as that submerged rooted hydrophytes.